And that brings me to one that's really excelled, is our speaker today, Mark Lanier. He was listed as one of the 10 best courtroom lawyers in America. And after you hear him speak, you'll know why he's the best. He's a Lubbock High boy. He came to Texas Tech. He graduated from law school here and went with Fulbright and Jaworski, and then started his own firm 5 years later. And he didn't have anything but hope and courage and a lot of ability and a lot of desire. You're just like the people I mentioned. In this crowd, there's someone that can be a member of Congress, a CEO, that, you know, you can do anything because this is Texas Tech. You have an advantage over everyone else. And when you get through hearing our speaker, you'll know you have a great advantage. I present to you Mark Lanier, a Texas Tech graduate.
All right. What a wonderful night. Congratulations to you. I get to address some fantastic people as you add to the many accomplishments you've already earned in your life, the graduate degree that you're earning tonight. My graduate degree is a Juris Doctor from Texas Tech University. I got it in May of 1984, and I wear it proudly every day all over this country when I'm in a courtroom. The degree you're getting tonight is a degree that you not only take with pride tonight, but it's a degree you take with pride the rest of your life. This is a hinge event, a turning event, a corner you turn tonight. If you're getting a master's degree tonight, somewhere around 5% of Americans at this point in their lives are pursuing and will get a master's degree. That's it. If you're getting a doctorate degree tonight, only around 3% of Americans. It is something that sets you apart. And as I address you, I'm cognizant of the fact that it's 7:30 or so at night. It's dinner time. So I want to urge you at this moment to consider the life before you an all-you-can-eat buffet. You've got your tray. You're scoping out the line. You see the little cubes of Jell-O and the salad. You see all the veggies and mashed potatoes. You know there's meat somewhere down there, and at the end there's going to be coconut cream pie. And you've got to decide, how am I going to attack this buffet? Well, I think if I could give you anything at all, if your life is truly a buffet and my analogy holds, then I'm going to suggest to you the 10 rules of buffets, a la Mark Lanier. If I'm with you and we're eating at the buffet, here are the rules we're going to follow. Number 10, pick the things you like. Don't waste your time eating stuff that you know is horrible. What's the point? You would never go through a buffet line with your tray and tell the kindly people working there, "Oh, I don't care. Just put on whatever you'd like." That's the sure way to get liver and onions. No one's going to do that. You don't do it in a buffet line, and you should never do it in your life. Don't let someone else tell you how to live your life and what to do with your life. You make the choices. Don't default into life, where you wake up each day, do the things that have to be done that day, and no more. Dream your dream and then live it. It's just a matter of choosing to do that and putting the effort behind it. Number 9, try something new on the buffet line. Now, pickled okra. Who likes pickled okra by looking at it? Nobody. I dare say it's that putrid color of green. It's slimy. It's got like little horny things on it. Looks almost satanic. But it actually tastes pretty good if you can bring yourself to try it. And I want you to try something new regularly in your life. Read a book outside of what you would normally read. Take up a new hobby. Decide you're going to develop a skill that you did not have before. Develop a relationship that might seem strange to you. Someone outside the norm of who you might consider a social friend. Do something new. Keep growing. Don't let this graduate degree be the apex moment in your life. Let it be a stepping stone to more and more as you continue to grow and learn. Rule number 8 in the buffet line. Run for the hot pizza. If you're at the CC's buffet, the kids are going to beat you to the hot pizza, and they're going to leave you getting the cold stuff that's got pineapple on it that nobody else wants. You want the pepperoni? You've got to make a run for it. You got to be looking in the kitchen. You got to be figuring out when they're coming out with it, when they're cutting it, and you got to strategically block the 8-year-olds from getting there first because they will take every slice. Do not let your lack of preparation, do not let your lack of focus, do not let your fear keep you from making that decision that has to be made at that moment. Get yourself prepared. There are some times in life where you can sit and contemplate for seemingly eternity, but there are some decisions in life that you will not make if you don't make them when that opportunity to make the decision is there, and you'll miss it. And the way to make those decisions is to be prepared for them. Have your wits about you. Have your eyes open. Be constantly thinking of what's out there and how it might come about. And when you've got that opportunity, don't fail to jump on it because you're afraid. Next rule of the buffet line. Avoid the half-eaten piece of chicken. You don't know that story. Our daughter Gracie was 4 years old, our daughter Rachel too. We're going through the buffet line. I've got the 4-year-old Gracie, Becky has the 2-year-old Rachel. There's this massive vat of thick brown goo they called gravy. And in that vat are pieces of chicken waiting for you to select them. This was a self-serve buffet. I think my 4-year-old Gracie likes chicken. We'll give her a piece of chicken. We take a piece out. We put it on her plate. I take Gracie over to the table. I sit her down, say, "Stay here, honey. I'm going to go back and help Becky with your sister." I go back and help Becky with Rachel, the 2-year-old. As Becky, Rachel, and I are coming to the table, there's no Gracie. I look up and our 4-year-old is coming back from the buffet line with her plate. I said, "Did you go back and get some more food?" She said, "No, Daddy. I took a bite of the chicken and it didn't taste very good, so I put it back." What's the dad to do? Oh, I went back. I rummaged through the dark gravy looking for that half-eaten piece of chicken to no avail. Don't eat the half-eaten piece of chicken. What do I mean by that in terms of life? Avoid the garbage. I cannot tell you. I'm 51 years old, and I have lost count of the number of friends and acquaintances I know who have radically messed up their life by eating the garbage. And if you said to them, "You're eating garbage," the response would be, "Lighten up. That's okay. This is me." The heart is deceitful above all things, Pascal said, and I believe he was correct. Garbage is garbage. Don't eat it. Don't drink it. Don't find yourself out of control to it. Next rule, rule number 6. We'll do this one quickly. It's not the fun rule. You got to eat some veggies. Okay, look, broccoli, yeah, it's tolerable. Asparagus, it's okay, but too much of that stuff is probably really healthy. But you got to eat at least some of it. There are some things in life you need to do for your own good. They may not be fun, they may not be tasty, they may not look appetizing, but they're what you need. And you want to grow and you want to develop and you want to have a body that functions as well as it can. And that means that you need to do the things that need to be done. You need to make wise choices that help you grow physically, emotionally, spiritually, socially. Rule number 5. Watch out. Watch out. There's someone you don't see who is selling you that buffet. I want to repeat that. There is someone that you don't see who is selling you that buffet. There's a book out, came out a couple of years ago called Nudge. And it talked about all of the different ways the social scientists have learned to nudge people's behavior. And by nudge, they mean put you in a position where they're manipulating you to do something without you even realizing it. One of the classic examples is the buffet line. Study after study has shown that people have a tendency to put more of the early buffet items on their plate than the later items. So restaurants will put those items that are cheaper, where the profit margin is larger, at the front of the line. There's a reason the first station you come to at the buffet is not prime rib. I'll take 18 slices of that. You won't get to the prime rib station until your plate's already filled up with the cheap stuff. The lettuces, the powdered mashed potatoes that sprawl out on the plate, leaving no room for the expensive meat. It's interesting also, school districts are faced with this perplexing problem with children. Do they put things that help them stay under budget, i.e. the cheap, malnutritious food at the front, or do they nudge the children's behavior to eat nutritious food, putting it at the front, even if it costs them their budget? That's a side issue. I'm just telling you that you are in the plans of other people. And there are people who will try to use you, manipulate you, and abuse you. Now, that's not the most positive, encouraging thing I can tell you, but it's the truth. And my encouragement to you is not only don't ever be that kind of a person, but live your life with your eyes open and see things for what they really are. Rule number 4, there is no such thing as a free lunch. You will have to pay the bill for your buffet. Everything comes at a price. When you have a decision to make, you can do cost-benefit analysis. How much is this going to cost me, and what are the benefits that I will derive from this? Is this action socially redeemable? Is this action beneficial? As you weigh the benefits, as you consider the costs, your decision-making should become not only better informed, but wiser. Now the big three, the final three rules. Rule number three, save room for dessert. Okay, all work and no play makes for a dull girl or boy. There is a time to have fun in life. Tonight is one of them. There is a time to sit back and enjoy the moment. Oh yes, the speaker goes on too long with this petty little thing about food. It is, after all, time to eat. But you need to enjoy the moment. What you've done is no small thing. You've stuck it out. You've endured long nights. Just getting into graduate school is a major accomplishment. Finishing, amazing. You've got to be able to enjoy life. It goes by way too fast. Rewards are an important part of it. Rule number two, don't be a glutton. If you live your life trying to figure out how to feed yourself and only yourself, if your life is targeted around your appetite and your desires and your wants, your life will be poorer, as will the lives of those around you. There's not a person in here that doesn't have a talent and doesn't have a gift and doesn't have an ability unique to themselves. And it means that you have a unique opportunity to help change the world. It's an incredible calling, and it's an incredible chance that each one of you hold. And I urge you to find it, to live your life with others in mind. Last and final rule of the buffet. After you've gone through, after you've gotten your food, after you've paid the bill, or at least gotten the check, knowing how much it will be later, find a really fun table. Sit down with your family, sit down with your friends, and enjoy your meal. Life is best when it's spent in the companionship of others. The people you've met along life's way, the people you've met at Texas Tech, are contact people for you that you should keep forever. I asked Chancellor Hans, 1965 graduate, Texas Tech University. I said, did you know Regent Turner, who graduated 3 years later in 68? He said, know him. He was in my dorm. He was next door to me. Then he thought for a moment and he said, and if I'd have known he was going to be chairman of the Board of Regents, I wouldn't have yelled at him so much to turn down his music. The relationships you make are relationships that you can choose to have 30, 40, God willing, 50 years down the road. This is your network starting. These are people who can help you find a job, get a job, keep a job. These are people who can help you identify issues and problems and opportunities. We live in the social networking age. There's more ways to socially network on your cellular phone than I ever could have expected when I was graduating. Use it. Don't lose track of it. And don't lose track of your school. Anything you do to help Texas Tech University, you give $5 out of each paycheck to help Texas Tech University. You're helping your own degree. So, my encouragement to you, Life's a buffet. The food is set out. The buffet is all before you. I trust that you are hungry, and I trust that you are ready, and I urge you to go feast for the rest of your life. God bless you, and congratulations.
Thank you very much, Mr. Lanier, for a marvelous presentation.